guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do another episode in me and Paula's series here on YouTube. This is a series where we shop our stash for a certain color in our collection, our eyeshadow collection. And today's episode is going to be all about cranberry red. And we thought it was the perfect color for Thanksgiving. We don't celebrate Thanksgiving in Denmark, but Paula really wanted to do cranberry, so we are doing cranberry. Cranberry for me is like a maroon, Bordeaux, dark red, kind of brownish shade. So when I was pulling out my palettes and I was like, oh, there's a cherry red, cranberry red, whatever. And I just kept going until I had like 7 palettes left in my collection. So we are going to swatch a lot of eyeshadow today. Just warning you a little bit. There are both matte and shimmers in this, and they're not perfect, but we're shopping our stash for this color, so we certainly don't need any more of that certain color. Let's just get into it. There's a lot to go through. Oh, and if you haven't already, check out Paula. She will be linked down below as always, but if you follow me, you must follow her. She's amazing, and I talk about her all the time on my channel, and I do a lot of collabs, project planning collabs with her, so you should check her out, and she will be linked down below. Let me start out with my smallest palettes that I pulled out, and the first shadow I'm going to talk about is from the NYX Full Throttle, I don't know how to pronounce that, Throttle. Throttle. I don't know. But this is called Color Riot. It is a quad from NYX and I really love it. This is the shade that I am going to swatch right there. And for me, that is the perfect cranberry Bordeaux color. That is going to be our first swatch for today. Stunning. It's beautiful. It's pigmented. It's perfect. The next one is from my W7 The Naughty 9 in Midsummer Nights. I should know what this is called. This is what it is looking like, and I'm going to swatch that one right there. This is a shimmer, if I can, for my nails. I didn't think about that. I have long nails. So this is the color with a little bit of the other one underneath, but this is the color. Stunning. And my memory is almost full. One moment and I will go fix that. That is the color. Not very pigmented, but it is absolutely stunning on the eyes. Very subtle. I like it. Let me fix my memory card. One moment. Hopefully I can do this before my battery runs out. So this is just perfect timing. But I will do my best to make this kind of short, because there's a lot to go through. The next eyeshadow that I'm going to swatch is from the new Tube palette from The Balm. And this is a little bit more dark, but it is a cranberry red in my eyes. This is the one right there. This is called Sexy. Yeah, it's more of a dark, plummy, Bordeaux cranberry red color. This is what I would go for if I was going to make a cranberry kind of look. These three shadows will be perfect. It is swatching a little bit more purple, and it is three different kind of pigmentation, so they look really, really different, but in the pans, I don't think they look that different. So if I'm going to swatch that one, I could have swatched this shade as well from the W7 palette, but I'm not. I have so much to go through. So much. Then we have the Balm Joey Rockstar palette. We are going to swatch that one right there. It is called Alice Copper. This is kind of a satin shimmer, kind of. I wouldn't call it a shimmer, but it is this one right here. I feel like this is very dark as well, but it has some shimmer shine to it. So totally different colors, I just realized, but kind of in the same color family. The BH Cosmetics Color Festival Shadow Palette. What was I going to swatch again? I forgot. That is purple. I don't know. Let me skip that. Then we have the BH Cosmetics Festival, Weekend Festival palette. And I am going to swatch that shadow right there. And that is called Saltish. It is a beautiful shimmer shadow. In the pan, this looks a lot like the W7 shadow. So I'm going to swatch it just beside that one. And you could definitely see what shadow is better quality and pigmentation. That is the BH Cosmetics one, and this is the W7 one. This is what I wanted the W7 one to be like. You can definitely see the difference. And I think it is supposed to be like this shadow, but it's not. So, yeah, I already have a favorite or a dupe for that one. Let's take some more W7 palettes, shall we? We have the W7 Delicious palette. And I am going to swatch without a cat hair, please. Please. Shoot. I am going to swatch that one right there. I know I could have swatched these two, but I actually think this is more cranberry red. I don't know. These don't have names, but it is the dupe for the Modern Renaissance, so you would know what that is called in the Modern Renaissance one. This is not very pigmented either. But it is there, this one right there. Now my nail is dirty. W7 on the rocks. And I am I'm going to swatch Maraschino Cherry. This one right there. This is a little bit like the Balm Nude shadow. So I'm going to swatch it next to that one. I just think this is a little bit more burgundy and plummy. This one right there. So I actually prefer that one over that. I know it's not a comparison video, but I can't help myself. W7 Life's a Peach palette. There's kind of a cranberry plummy shade here as well. That one right there. But I think it's more plum. A little bit more purple. Let's just swatch it, why not? This is a little bit more light, but I think it is kind of a cranberry shade, that one right there. Then we have a shimmer shadow, and this is from the W7 Dusk Till Dawn palette. And I am going to swatch Dune Moon, which is this one right there. I'm going to do it kind of on top of everything, I'm sorry. But this is the shadow right there. You can still see that this and this, so excuse me. But this is a little bit more, well, it is a shimmer, but this, and then the BH Cosmetics one is a little bit more metallic. I have the W7 Romance palette. A lot of W7 palettes, apparently they look like each other. I have the shade Crush, which is this one right there. I think this is a little bit, maybe it's more coppery. I'm going to swatch it. I don't care. It's a little bit more coppery, but it is what it is. This one right there. W7 Violet Lights palette. I still haven't used this on my eyes. I feel bad a little bit. I'm going to swatch. What was I going to swatch? Butterfly or Chemical Reaction? I think it was Butterfly. That one right there. So let me go do that. This shade right there. Not the best one, but here it is. You can see a lot of different tones. But if I grabbed a palette and I was looking for a cranberry, these are the shades I would go for. Then we have the Spaced Out palette from W7, and I am going to swatch that one right there. And this is called Earth. I don't know what to do with this palette. Maybe I'm going to try to use it a little bit more in another way than I did last time. It's not my favorite. It looks a little bit more brown when you swatch it, but this is the shadow right here. Then we have the Enchanted palette. You have seen this a lot on my channel because I have panned a Mystical right here. I hate pan on it. And I am going to swatch Bouquet. This one right there. I loved working on it. And I brought it with me to England. And I wore it when John proposed to me. I don't have my ring on, I just realized. But it will be special to me. So I can't get rid of the palette ever. Then this is the shadow right there. Another shimmer. This is a beautiful hand in my eyes. This one right there. Is this the last W7 palette? I think so. This is the Metal Pop palette. An old shimmer, or soft metallic shimmers, which is just shimmers in my eyes. I'm going to swatch that shadow right there. And these don't have names either, which is a little bit sad, but let me go swatch that shade. A little bit crumbly, but that is just the formula of this shadow. A little bit more plummy as well, I think. That is the one right there. A little bit more purple, but it's there. It's really hard to tell the difference when you just look at the shadow and then when you actually swatch it. And that is why we are going to do these kind of videos to get to know our eyeshadow collection a little bit better. I have the Luna Beauty Life's a Drag palette. I crossed my fingers if there wasn't a cranberry red, but I was wrong. There's one right there. I didn't think there was one, but this is a cranberry, yeah. It's a beautiful cranberry though, but it's there. And I'm going to swatch it. And that is looking a lot like the NYX one right there. That is actually, and it is a little bit more red and a little bit more cranberry looking than the NYX palette. Which is a good thing in my eyes, because that means it's not the same. But it's kind of a dupe in my collection, which I'm fine with. The next two palettes are from Too Faced, and this is the Gingerbread palette that I'm going to swatch. Or am I? Or maybe? Yeah, let's just do it, just because I can. Hot Toddy, that one right there, one of my favorite shades. Yeah. Paula, if you're not swatching this, I don't know what you are. Oh, that looks a lot like the BH Cosmetic Festival, Weekend Festival shadow. That is the shadow right there. And that is the BH one. A little bit more red on this one right here, but they're pretty much the same thing. I'm excited about that because it is a beautiful shadow. So I'm not going to run out of it right away. My very loved chocolate bar from Too Faced. I'm going to cover the shadow that I am working on, but I'm going to swatch Cherry Cordial. This is the maroon shade in this. I don't think I'm going to swatch Amaretto. This is a little bit more dark red, but I actually quite enjoy it. It's just really hard to pan because it's hard pressed. The whole Too Faced chocolate bar is actually. And this is, of course, not looking red at all. But it is a cranberry red, or cherry red. I don't know why it's not looking. Can you see that is not brown? That one? It's not brown. I assure you, it's not brown, but it's brown here. The Morphe palette that I'm panning this year, it is the 35OM. You can see how beaten up it is looking. That is for laying on my makeup table for 11 months. I'm going to swatch that shadow right there. I know it looks a lot like a red on camera, but it's a little bit more deep in real life. This is the shadow right here. I don't think there's any other shade in this palette that could be a cranberry. I don't think this is 100%. But it's really, really close. It's very orange compared to the next one. But that is the shade right there. It can work. It can work. It is a little bit more bright cranberry. Why am I justifying it? Why am I doing that? I don't want to, but I think I'm going to swatch two shades from the Zodiac Love Signs palette. We're almost done, guys. Almost done. I have filmed in forever. I'm going to swatch the shimmer shade from Taurus, I think it is called. And then I'm going to swatch that matte shadow from the Gemini row. These two shades. These shimmers. I'm so surprised every single time, and I shouldn't because they're just amazing. Yep, that is looking like the Too Faced Gingerbread Shadow and the BS Cosmetics one. These two right there. So stunning. So I have three of that color now. Impressive. Impressive. I didn't think I had any dupes, but boy, was I wrong. The last shade that I am going to swatch, we're ending on a bad note. I don't think this is completely cranberry, but the last shadow that I'm going to swatch is from my Zodiac palette from BS Cosmetics. And that is the shimmer shadow from Libra. That one right there. It looks a little bit more purple, but let's do it. Just because it is the last shadow and I don't have any battery on my camera. So that is just perfect. It's a little bit more purple. I can't even. Can I? No. Me. Why am I doing this to myself? That shadow right there. This is the most awkward angle with my hand ever. I already regret swatching it there. That is the one right there. So, that was the last shadow that I'm going to swatch for you guys. And let me just show you my hand. This is what it is looking like. I love it. The different tones and pigmentation and formulas in this cranberry stash that I have here for myself. Yeah, it's beautiful though. I love it. So that is everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I actually really enjoyed swatching all of these, and I was very surprised of how they turned out on my hand compared to the pan in the palette. But that is why we are doing this series, getting to know our collection a little bit more and justifying to ourselves why we should not buy another cranberry shadow for once. Like, you don't need any more, Elizabeth. You don't need any more. And I don't think Paula needs any more too. I have not seen what she has watched and how many, but if you compare, if you even can compare her eyeshadow stuff to mine, she has a lot more eyeshadow than me, so she must have a lot of cranberry shades as well. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you haven't already checked out Paula, you should definitely do so. I will link her and her video down below in the description box, and I hope you enjoyed, and until my next video, please take care. Bye. Look at my fingers. Oh my god. Bye.